Greetings. Well, I received a reply attempting to show the Quran's position on Allah's guidance. And I'd like to go through the ayat with you. Quran 42:51. And it is impossible for a human being that Allah spoke to him except through revelation or behind a veil or by sending a messenger, angel, and reveal to him by his permission what he wills. Verily, he is most high, most wise. Let's take that a little more slowly. And it is impossible. Impossible, meaning not possible. The thing the Quran is about to describe cannot happen. Impossible for a human being that Allah spoke to him. It would seem that does not need explanation. But this is in response to how can Allah guide you? And this is from the Quran, offered as evidence how Allah speaks to men. But do not focus too heavily on this yet. Except. That is an important word which we must understand. In the context of, it is impossible for Allah to speak to a man. However, except, but, wait. This is true for absolutely all cases except the following. The Quran is about to make this clear. These are the exceptions, the special cases, where Allah can speak to men. It would seem then this is the perfect on-point reply from the Quran. Except, one, through revelation, or two, behind a veil, or three, by sending a messenger, angel. So point one, except through revelation. Except through revelation. Think about this. The Quran says Allah can speak to you by revelation, and that makes you a prophet. If Allah can give any man a revelation, and this revelation occurs after Muhammad, after the Quran, you have a problem, my Muslim brother. Muhammad is not the last prophet. This is a contradiction in the Quran, brother. If Muhammad is the last prophet, Allah can never again give revelation to a man. Except two, behind a veil. Except behind a veil or a curtain. This is a statement of physical proximity, like the Wizard of Oz. Allah standing behind a curtain. But that means Allah must have physically entered his creation. And Islam claims Allah cannot enter his creation. This is also the same contradiction in the Quran, brother. If Allah can hide behind a curtain and speak, and if you and those with you can hear him, you are all prophets. And that contradicts that Muhammad is the last prophet. Except three, by sending a messenger or angel. Notice the translator edition, angel. The Arabic word is transliterated Rasulun from corpus.quran.com, an accusative masculine indefinite noun. And I wondered if this is the same word used synonymously with Muhammad, a release from Allah and his messenger, or Quran 2:279. If you do not, then be warned of war from Allah and his messenger. Wa Rasulihi. Quran 3:172. Those who responded to Allah and the messenger. Wa al Rasuli. Quran 4:100. And if anyone leaves home as a migrant towards Allah and his messenger. Wa Rasulihi. Now, I dug for a while and found I was chasing different words that were translated as messenger. But they all share the root word, Rasul. So I returned to the original Ayat to see how knowledgeable academics translated the phrase. Surah 42:51, the Asad, or by sending an apostle to reveal. Apostle, not angel. The Pickthall, or that he sendeth a messenger to reveal. Messenger, without angel as a qualifier or clarifier. Shakir, this is the whole ayat, and it is not for any mortal that Allah should speak to them. They could not bear to hear, and they did not see. Beep, beep, back up the truck. This looks nothing like other translations. In fact, this contradicts the assertion of any communication. They could not bear to hear, and they did not see. Is this yet another example of a Quran so confused and so unclear, skilled translators cannot discern what it means? The Yusuf Ali, or by the sending of a messenger to reveal. The Bakhtiar, or that he send a messenger to reveal. The Wahidudikan, or by sending him a messenger so that the messenger may reveal. No angel qualifier added. Irving, or by sending a messenger. Again, no angel qualifier. Al-Muntakab, or through a spirit who would actuate him. There's a new term here, spirit. But this is Al-Muntakab the wordy. But actuate? Really? The monotheist group, or by sending a messenger to inspire. Again, no angel qualifier. The Halim translation, or by sending a messenger to reveal. Again, no angel qualifier. The Ahmed Ali, it is not given to man that Allah should speak to him except by suggestion or indirectly, or send a messenger to convey. Again, no angel qualifier. But by suggestion or indirectly? How exactly is the suggestion communicated? The Bewley, and he sends a messenger who then reveals. Again, no angel qualifier. The Ali Yunal, or by sending a messenger, angel to reveal. Another angel noted as a translator addition. This simply does not help the Quran's cause and claims, brother. Messenger is clearly unclear. If it means a man, then another prophet is sent to guide you. If the messenger is an angel, then you are a prophet receiving revelation. Allah simply cannot guide you without violating the integrity of the claims of Muhammad's Quran. If the messenger is an angel, then you are a prophet receiving revelation. This is exactly how Muhammad claimed he received his revelation as a prophet. So if an angel gives you Allah's revelation, you are a prophet. And Muhammad is not the last prophet, the seal of the prophets. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.